बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम टेंथ क्लास, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू विल बी फाइन। यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट नॉलेज इज ऑफ नो वैल्यू अनलेस यू पुट इट इनटू प्रैक्टिस। अस्सलाम वालेकुम टेंथ क्लास, आई होप यू विल बी फाइन एंड यू आर एंजॉयिंग दिस ऑनलाइन सेशन। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू मैथमेटिक्स इन विच वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट नंबर 2 विच इज़ नेम्ड एज थ्योरी ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशंस। As we know that quadratic equations are the equations that contains the square of unknown variable but no higher power. It means that ऐसी equations जिसमें हम एक variable use करते हैं और उस variable की highest power must be 2. So that's why these equations are called the equations of second degree. For example, you can see an equation ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. This is an example of quadratic equation because in this equation here is only one unknown variable which is x and the highest power of this variable is 2. This equation is also called the equation of second degree. In this equation, a, b and c are considered as real numbers. We can also say that a is the coefficient of x square, b is the coefficient of x and c is a constant number. Today our topic is synthetic division. Synthetic division में हम two polynomials को divide करते हैं and we can find quotient and remainder by using this division. So we can define it as synthetic division is the process of finding the quotient and remainder. Quotient is the answer of the division and remainder is a term that is left after the division process. When a polynomial is divided by a linear polynomial, लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल इज अ पॉलिनोमियल हुज डिग्री इज 1। अगर किसी पॉलिनोमियल की डिग्री हाईएस्ट पावर 1 हो तो फिर हम उसे कह सकते हैं लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल। सिंथेटिक डिवीजन में हम एक पॉलिनोमियल को लीनियर पॉलिनोमियल से डिवाइड करते हैं फॉर फाइंडिंग द कोशेंट एंड रिमाइंडर। इनफैक्ट सिंथेटिक डिवीजन इज सिंपली द शॉर्ट फॉर्म ऑफ लॉन्ग डिवीजन मेथड। बहुत लंबी डिवीजन को अवॉइड करने के लिए हम सिंथेटिक डिवीजन यूज करते हैं। Here we have to solve question number 1 from exercise 2.6. Use the synthetic division to find the quotient and remainder. हमने synthetic division के जरिए quotient और remainder find करना है। The question is given as x square plus 7x minus 1 is divisible by x plus 1. Here x square plus 7x minus 1 is a polynomial and is called dividend. The second polynomial which is called linear polynomial x plus 1 and is called divisor. Divisor is always taken as x minus a. तो x plus 1 को x minus a की फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट करने के लिए हम लिख सकते हैं x minus into minus 1. So the value of a equal to minus 1. First of all we have to write the coefficient of the dividend in the first row. The coefficient of the dividend are 1, 7 and minus 1. On the left side, we have to write the value of a which is minus 1. Now we have to write the first term as it is under the horizontal line. First number is 1, so we will write 1 as it is. Now we have to multiply 1 with minus 1 which will give us minus 1. We have to write this product under the number 7. And by adding both these terms, we get 6. Now we have to multiply 6 and minus 1 on the left side which will give us minus 6. We have to write minus 6 under the number minus 1. By adding these terms we get minus 7. Minus 7 is the last term, so we can say this is the remainder. And the other two terms can be written as 1 into x plus 6 equal to x plus 6. So the quotient is x plus 6 and remainder is minus 7. Now we have to solve next question. In this question we have to find the quotient and remainder by using a synthetic division. The question is given as 4x cube minus 5x plus 15 is divisible by x plus 3. Here 4x cube minus 5x plus 15 is dividend and x plus 3 is called divisor. We have to divide both these polynomials. First of all, we will write the divisor in the form of x minus a So we can write x plus 3 equal to x minus minus 3. So the value of a is minus 3. Now we have to write the coefficients of dividend in the first row. And we have to write the coefficient of the dividend in a row with 0 as the coefficient of the missing powers of x in the descending order. अगर डिवाइडेंड में x की कोई भी पावर मिसिंग है तो उसकी प्लेस पे हम 0 राइट करेंगे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल x क्यूब इज गिवन बट x स्क्वायर इज मिसिंग इन द डिवाइडेंड. सो वी हैव टू राइट 0 इन प्लेस ऑफ x स्क्वायर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल राइट 4, देन वी विल राइट 0. आफ्टर दिस वी विल राइट माइनस 5 विच इज द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ x, एंड इन द लास्ट वी विल राइट कॉन्स्टेंट नंबर 15. Now we have to write the value of a on the left side, which is minus 3, and under the horizontal line we have to write first number 4 as it is. Here we have to take the product of 4 and minus 3, which is equal to minus 12. We have to write minus 12 under the number 0, and by adding both these numbers we can write minus 12. Now we have to take product of minus 12 and minus 3, which is equal to 36. We have to write 36 under minus 5. By adding minus 5 and 36 we get 31. By taking the product of 31 and minus 3 we get minus 93. We have to write minus 93 under 15. By taking the sum of 15 and minus 93 we get minus 78. Minus 78 is the last number, so we can say this is the remainder, and the remaining terms can be written as 4 into x square minus 12x plus 31, which is called quotient, and remainder equal to minus 78. In this question we have to find the value of h using synthetic division. If 3 is the 0 of the polynomial 2x cube minus 3h x square plus 9. As the equation is given as p of x equal to 2x cube minus 3h x square plus 9 and a equal to 3, it is also given. सबसे पहले हम given polynomial के coefficients write करेंगे first row में, which are 2, minus 3h, 0 and 9. Here we write 0 because the term x is missing here, so the coefficient of x is 0. Now we have to write the value of a on the left hand side, which is 3, and then we have to write the first number 2 under the line as it is. By taking the product of 2 and 3 we get 6, so we write 6 under the term minus 3h. By adding both these terms we can write 6 minus 3h. Now we have to take product of 6 minus 3h and 3, which is equal to 18 minus 9h. So we will write this product under the number 0. By taking the sum of 0 and 18 minus 9h, we can write 18 minus 9h. Now we have to take product of 18 minus 9h and 3, which will give us 54 minus 27h. We have to write this product under the number 9. By adding both these numbers 9 and 54 minus 27h, we get 63 minus 27h. As the last term is 63 minus 27h, so this is called remainder. It is given that 3 is the 0 of the polynomial, therefore remainder equal to 0. Now we have to compare both these remainders. For this we can write 63 minus 27h equal to 0. It can also be written as 63 equal to 27h. Dividing both sides by 27, we get the value of h, which is equal to 63 over 27, which can also be written in the reduced form as h equal to 7 by 3. This question can also be solved by using the previous method. In this question we have to find the value of h using synthetic division if minus 1 is the 0 of the polynomial 2x cube plus 5hx minus 23. First of all we have to write the polynomial p of x equal to 2x cube plus 5hx minus 23. The value of a is given, which is minus 1. By using synthetic division, first of all we have to write the coefficients of the polynomial. If any one coefficient is missing, then we have to write 0 in place of that number. as the coefficient of x cube is 2, so we will write 2 firstly. The coefficient of x square is missing, so we will write 0 in place of coefficient of x square. The coefficient of x is 5h and the last term is minus 23. Now we have to write the value of a on the left side, which is minus 1. And next we will write the first number as it is under the horizontal line, which is 2. By taking the product of 2 and minus 1, we get minus 2. So we will write minus 2 under the number 0. By taking the sum of 0 and minus 2, we get minus 2, which is written under the horizontal line. Now we have to take product of minus 2 and minus 1, which is equal to 2. We will write this product under the number 5h. By adding both these terms, we can write 2 plus 5h. And next we have to take product of 2 plus 5h and minus 1, which will give us minus 2 minus 5h. We will write this product under the number minus 23. By adding both these terms, minus 23 and minus 2 minus 5h, we get minus 25 minus 5h. Here, minus 25 minus 5h is the last term, so we can say this is remainder. It is given that minus 1 is the 0 of the polynomial. Therefore, remainder equal to 0. By comparing both these remainders, we can write minus 25 minus 5h equal to 0. By moving the constant term to the other side, we can write minus 25 equal to 5h. And dividing both sides by 5, we get the value of h as minus 25 over 5, which can also be written in the reduced form as h equal to minus 5. In this way, you can find quotient and remainder by using a synthetic division. Now you have to solve this exercise and you have to give your best. Thanks to all of you for sharing your precious time. Allah Hafiz.